Some may find their path on land. Ted Cooney's came from the water.
I finally figured out what I'm gonna do when I grow up.
Once a Peace Corps worker in the Congo specializing in aquaculture, a wooden boat builder in England, and a commercial fisherman in Alaska, Cooney has traveled the world, but has always stayed by the water.
All of those things were just leading to a point, and this is that point.
Cooney started Madhouse Oyster Company 2 years ago. Here on his oyster farm, Cooney helps to raise the numbers of these shellfish on the Chesapeake Bay.
We'll never have what we once had here. No matter how many oysters I raise, it's a drop in the bucket compared to what used to come out of the bay.
Couldn't be better.
But it could still be a really viable industry.
An industry that not only helps the economy, but one that helps with improving the health of the waters in and around the bay.
There is no loser here, you know, and I mean, the water gets cleaner. The guys that are making a living have a resource that they can continually renew. The government is really on our side. They want to see this industry succeed.
And tonight, Cooney has brought Madhouse Oysters to the largest fundraising event of the year for Oyster Recovery Partnership.
Oyster farming is just a way to take a little bit of the pressure off the wild harvest.
And helps implement the government's plan to restore what is now 1% of the original oyster population in the bay. Cooney admits it's a tough job.
We're essentially growing rocks for a living.
But Cooney says it's all worth it.
And then we get feedback, you know. Somebody says, oh, I really like your website. I like your label. Your oysters taste different than other people. I'm like, ooh, you know, there's hope.
On the Eastern Shore, Joyce Koh, CNS-TV.